Sometimes it is confusing in the Rhino 3D software in between the unroll, smash, create UV curve. I would like to take a look on all of these three all together today and tell you the difference between those three. Hi, I'm PJ Chen, an authorized Rhino trainer. Let's get started. In the Rhino 3D, unroll, smash, and create UV curve, they both serve the same function for try to flatten the surface so you can work it on flat. People using unroll doing some paper craft. If we go to Google and then you can search for the Pepakura. Pepakura in Japanese means paper craft. You can see a lot of people using Pepakura, which is a software. It can flatten your 3D image into 2D and then also giving the tab so you can kind of glue it back together after laser cut, glue it back together. So you'll get a 3D object. And once you work on those, you can use a fiberglass and make them into the mask and make it harder, sort of things. So group of people is working on this beautiful craft skill by using Pepakura. However, in the Rhino, you can achieve the same thing using Unroll. Okay, so right here I have a block. I'm gonna use Unroll command. So write a command, I type it Unroll, Unroll Surface. And once you type it, you have the option if you wanna explode it. We don't want to explode it at this point, and then we don't want to label, okay? And then once you click it, it will usually happen where it at 0 point. You have something like this. That means all the surface right here is now flat. And then if you kind of fold it back together and put a tab, you can kind of make a paper craft out of it, okay? So what happened if I use the command smash on the same object? Here what we go is we will use the smash, and then you can type it smash, or you can go to the surface tool. It's really fun. Under the surface edit tool, you have a look like a cap being run over. All right, so we're gonna use the smash tool. And then we're working on, we don't want to explode it. And then let's see what happened. It come up the same result here. So with that saying, if you have the surface is completely flat, it doesn't matter the command that you use, okay? Let's take a look on our second one. The second one is a little bit twist on the surface. So we're gonna use the same command, it's called unroll surface, and then we're gonna click on this object and we hit we don't want to explode it, and then we hit enter. Okay, you'll see the object right here. But before we do more action, let's enlarge this area for our, you can go back to look at the command that you did. Right here it says 2.65% bigger after unroll. So the surface, if you have this surface, let's say I'm gonna move this surface here and I'm going to explode it, and then all the pieces, if you try to glue it back together, it will be 2.65 bigger than this one on the model. Okay, so let's take a look again with smash. Let's type it smash. And it will ask you which surface, and then we want to pick up the whole second solid, and then we hit enter, and again you will come up with the same thing, 2.65 bigger than unroll surface, bigger than the original surface. So that means in this case I'm using unroll and using smash, they all the same, okay? Whether you have the flat surface or you have have them twist a little bit. Now let's take a look on this one. The shape is coming from a sphere, and I just chop off the top and the bottom. So let's use the unroll command. So type it here, unroll surface, and it says you can unroll this surface because it has a doubly curve. Alright, so unroll surface, it doesn't apply to the surface has doubly curve. That means I'm curving from this direction, from the top to the bottom, and also right to the left. Right, so I have two curves, and then that doesn't work. Let's try the command for smash on this doubly curve. Alright, so we're gonna use the command smash smash, and then we'll pick up our surface, and then we hit enter, and right there it gives you a surface. But let's take a look on our command bar. Right here it says it's 39.15% smaller after unrolling. That means this surface is actually 40% smaller than what our original surface is. Okay, so it's not accurate when it applied to the doubly curved surface. Alright, in this case we need to use the create UV curve. Create UV curve leaving under the curve tool, and then you have curve from the object, and you have create UV curves. Okay, then we'll select our surface, and when you hit enter, it gives you two boxes. And why is that? It's because I was originally create this sphere and trim top and the bottom off. So the computer will remember what was it. So the one on the top represent the entire sphere, and the one in the middle is represent the surface that we have there. Okay, so let's do a comparison. I'm gonna make this smaller, and then I'm going to make this into the surface first by the planar curves here. Okay, so let's do analyze. We're going to analyze, and we're going to mesh property in the area. Okay, so I'm going to click on this one. All right, let me bring up the bar a little bit bigger. So this one's saying it is 3.58 square millimeter. Okay, let's take a look on this one. This one is 2.17, which is much smaller. And let's take a look on this one. It's 4.14 square millimeter. So we know this one after smash is almost 40% smaller. This one is currently 4.14 square millimeter. So I just did the calculation. It's like 15% bigger than what we have here, right? And why this is important is because a lot of time we are working on the graphic in 2D, and then we want to flow it back to the surface. Let's do a test here. I'm going to draw a simple, let's just draw a circle. I'm gonna put a circle right here and type it 0.25. So put a circle roughly in the middle, and I'm gonna put a circle right here roughly in the middle with the same size. We are going to use the command for flow along the surface to make this circle flow it back to the green surface. So here's what we do. We'll go to the transform, flow along surface. It will ask you the object. We want to pick up this object, and then we hit enter. We pick up one of the corner, and then we come into the surface and we pick up one of the corner. Okay. Right here you will see the ring is actually stretched a lot. So it's no longer not ring, it's a circle. The circle stretch a lot, so you kind of understand that 40% different when you doing a very delicate design, flow it back, it will kind of totally stretch. Okay, so let's take a look on this one. I'm going to do this one twice because I want to show you there's a little differences that people always forget to pick. I'm gonna use the surface which is really similar to our green surface. Okay, the same command we're going to use here is flow along the surface. Pick up the object, enter, pick up one of the corner, and then we'll come in here and we pick up one of the corner, and then it give me this curve. And then you say, hey PJ, it is only 15% different, why stretch that much? When you use the UV curve, a Rhino will remember what was the original size, even though you already trim it off. That's why it give you two square here. So when you flow it back, you need to remember to use the original one. So let's do another test. I'm going to use the same command, which is flow along surface is leaving under the transform. And then you will pick up the object, which is this circle, enter, and you pick one of the corner. Then we want to come in back here and we pick one of the corner. Now you can see the circle that I have, the third circle, it's much close to the original, even though it is stretched a little bit, but it's about 15% stretch. Okay, so this is the difference by using those three. You may be curious, why am I leaving those two blank? It's because the Create UV curve doesn't work on the poly surface. You only work on a single surface, one at a time. Even though if I wanted to have this be flattened, I'll better to use Unroll or Smash. But let me show you what I'm talking about. I want to use the Create UV curve on this block. So I'm going to the curve from the object, Create UV Curves. Then it will ask me the surface to create a UV curve. And I'm clicking on the whole thing, but it only let me select one of the surface. It's because it doesn't apply to the poly surface, all right? So then you will need to have, you will come up this and one at a time. So to do it faster, in this case, Unroll is and the Smash is better than Create UV curve. And just give you a recap, the reason we cannot have Unroll here is because it's doubly curved surface, so it doesn't work for Unroll. Unroll only work for the flat surface. Leave a comment below. Let me know what do you think about the video and what would you like to learn for Rhino 3D software. I will do my best to make a video for you. Please like and comment and share my video to help me to make more free video for you. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next Monday.